Bon matin à tous. Aujourd'hui, je vais vous expliquer un petit peu de comment mesurer des objets avec des unités non standardisées. Alors, en anglais, on dit « non-standard units of measurement ». En deuxième année, c'est juste ça qu'on utilise. Alors, on n'utilise pas les unités de mesure comme les centimètres, les décimètres, des choses comme ça. On utilise vraiment juste d'autres objets pour mesurer certaines choses. Je peux te dire pourquoi qu'on utilise d'autres objets. Des fois, dans la vraie vie, on n'a pas toujours quelque chose, une unité pour mesurer. On n'a pas toujours une règle ou d'autres choses comme ça. Alors, on peut utiliser d'autres objets pour mesurer quelque chose qui sont dans notre environnement. Mais quand on choisit notre unité non standardisée, c'est important de choisir quelque chose qui est uniforme. Alors, ici, j'ai des épingles à papier et j'en ai tout plein de la même grandeur. Alors, s'ils sont de la même grandeur, on peut les utiliser parce qu'ils sont uniformes. Par contre, si j'ai une trombone plus grande et une trombone plus petite, je ne peux pas les utiliser ensemble parce que la mesure va être obscure. Alors, elle ne sera pas bonne parce que j'ai pas les mêmes unités. Il faut toujours avoir des unités identiques. Alors, so I'll just kind of recap that in English a little bit. So today we're talking about measurement and how to do measurement using non-standard units. We use non-standard units. That's the only thing we use in grade 2 for our measurement unit. We don't use centimeters, decimeters, inches. In real life, we might be using non-standard units just in case you don't have a tape measure or a ruler around. So it's a good skill to learn. We are also talking about how to choose a good non-standard unit. The first thing that we need to choose is make sure that the object that you're choosing is uniform. That means that they are all the same size, sort of same length. So here I have paper clips that are all the same length. We could not, for example, use two small and one big paper clip because they are not uniform. Your answer would be skewed. It would not necessarily make sense because it would have some bigger and some smaller, so then your answer would not be exact. So you need to make sure that you're using the same things. Same thing if we were using coins. If you're using coins, you would want to use all 5-cent pieces and not 25 cents or 10 cents because, again, your answer would be skewed. So that is how you choose your non-standard unit, is make sure that, first of all, it's uniform. Then you're going to want to choose something depending on what you are measuring. Let's say we are measuring this pencil. This pencil is not very long, so we could use something like our 5-cent pieces. We could use something like paper clips. We could use sticky notes to measure. Those would all work. If I had multiple hangers, or if I had multiple copies of this book, it might not be our best choice because it's already bigger than what we're trying to measure. So we always want to measure, we always want to pick a non-standard unit that is smaller than the item that we're going to measure, and that is relatively the same size. So if we were going to measure this, if I put this, where do we see it? Here. What you would do is you would line up, always making sure that you are starting right at the end of your object, and then you would line up without overlapping your non-standard units of measurement to see how many equals your pencil. So here, if I'm starting right at the tip and I go all the way to the end, I have roughly 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 seven non-standard units. So we could say that, oops, that this pencil is roughly seven paper clips long. As you see at the end here, it is not exactly. So I want you to use your best judgment. We're going to round up or round down. So if I see that it's using up most of the paper clip, I'm going to count it. Let's say we were here and it is not using most of my paper clip, then I would take that one off and I would say it was only six paper clips long. And that's how you measure using your non-standard unit.